Hi there, my name is Jonathan. In this Lens Studio tutorial, I'll be showing you how to use the marker with a Snapcode template. The marker with a Snapcode template allows you to create a lens that will track your content to a Snapcode, then seamlessly to a custom image when it becomes visible. This template is great for creating a lens that overlays content onto images, such as a poster or a mural, where a Snapcode that unlocks the lens can be placed within or nearby. Before we get started, you should have a PNG or JPEG of the image you want to track with a Snapcode embedded to use as reference for laying out your scene. For now, any Snapcode is fine, since we will replace it once we've submitted our lens and received the real Snapcode. We've provided an example Snapcode on the template documentation page for convenience. Additionally, you will need both your image and Snapcode's width and height measurement. Let's get started. First, open Lens Studio and select the marker with a Snapcode template to create a new project. Let's set up markers for our content to track. The first thing we'll do is create our image marker. To do this, in the Resources panel, click Add New, Image Marker. In the File Selection window, choose the image you want to track your content to. Next, select Image Tracking in the Objects panel, and in the Inspector panel, select the Marker field, and in the pop-up, choose your newly created marker. Since we're tracking both a Snapcode and an image in this template, it is crucial that we set the size of these markers correctly, so that our lens can correctly relate them to each other. To do this, in the Resources panel, select Snapcode Marker in the Inspector panel. Set the marker height field to the height of your Snapcode in the physical world. Do the same for your image marker. Note, although the measurement unit is not as important as having the height of the two markers be in the same unit, it is optimal to use centimeters since that is what Lens Studio uses. Now that our trackers are proportionally scaled, we can position the Snapcode tracker to its correct position relative to the image marker. To do this, select Snapcode Tracking in your Objects panel, and in the Scene panel, use the Move widget to move your Snapcode to the place where the Snapcode is. The last step to setting up our tracker is to create a common reference point between the two trackers so that our content is tracked to a consistent position regardless of the marker. To do this, in the Objects panel, right-click the reference point under Image Tracking and press Duplicate. Then, drag the duplicate object into Snapcode Tracking. Finally, remove the reference point that came with the template. When you're done, each reference point should have the same position in the Scene panel. Now let's add our content. To import a 3D model into your scene, drag your file into the Objects panel. Once the file has been loaded, drag the new object into the Marker with Snapcode Controller object. Then, you can delete the existing My Scene Replace Me. You can then position, scale, and rotate your object in relation to your image in the Scene panel. One useful thing to do is to record a video with your marker and import it into the Preview panel so you can see how the lens would work. To do this, press the drop-down in the Preview panel, press Video, then Add New. Now select your video and click Open. Then, if you scroll up to the top of the list, you can now see your newly imported video. In the Preview panel, you should see your content being tracked to the image. Now that we've finished setting up our trackers and content, we can focus on the user's experience of using the lens. To help users understand that an image has been found, the template comes with a cross animation that begins at a point and expands outward. We want this to start at the Snapcode so that the animation begins where the user is looking. First, in the Objects panel, select Cross Controller. Then, in the Scene panel, move the object to where the Snapcode is. Next, we'll need to adjust the occluder so that it hides anything outside of our image. In the Objects panel, select Occluder Object. If you have the measurement of your image in centimeters, you can quickly size your occluder by going to the Inspector panel and modifying the Scale field to be the size of your image, with Scale X being the width and Scale Y being the height of your image. Alternatively, you can also scale using the Scale widget. The template also comes with a way to fade your content in or out, so that when the marker is found, the content magically appears. To use this effect, in the Resources panel, select the material which you want to fade, and in the Inspector panel, tick the box next to Fizzle. Then, select Mesh Fade Controller in the Objects panel, and in the Inspector panel, press Add Value. Select the new Value field, and in the pop-up, choose the material you've just modified. To select whether the Fizzle animation fades in or out, you can press the drop-down and choose the desired type. Lastly, since your content doesn't appear until your image is found, we need to tell the users to find the image. To do this, in the Objects panel, select Magnifying Hint, and in the Inspector panel, select the Preview Texture field. Then, in the pop-up window, press Add New, Import Files, and select your image. Now, in the preview panel, you should see your image in the center of the screen when the marker is not visible. Now, we're ready to preview and submit our lens. To do this, click Pair your device in the top right corner of Lens Studio. Then, open Snapchat and scan the provided Snapcode. Make sure your device and computer are on the same Wi-Fi network. When Snapchat and Lens Studio are connected, press the Push Lens to Device button. You can now preview your lens in Snapchat. Once you've tested that your lens works properly, we can submit the lens. To do this, click the Project Info button in the top left corner of Lens Studio. First, set the name of your lens. Then, select an image from your computer to set your lens icon. A lens icon is a 320 by 320 square image. The circle lens border of the icon is automatically applied to the square image when you set the icon. Now that you've given your lens an icon and a name, you're ready to submit. To submit your lens, click the Submit Lens button, also in the top left corner of Lens Studio. There, you'll be asked to log into your Snapchat account if you haven't already. Once logged in, confirm the submission by pressing Submit. When the lens is live, you'll get an email with the Snapcode. You can replace the placeholder Snapcode on your image for users to scan and unlock the lens. Your marker with the real Snapcode is now ready to be printed. The Marker with Snapcode template allows you to introduce a richer layer of experience to traditional images. This technique is perfect for visual artists and anyone interested in adding a new dimension to their work. Thanks for watching, and have fun creating your own lenses using the Marker with Snapcode template in Lens Studio.